Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today let's take a look at the new Titles and Captions feature of Pages. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 700 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign. Join us and get exclusive content and course discounts. So this is a new feature in Pages version 10.1. So make sure you have that version. And what you can do with this is you can easily add captions and titles to things like images. So let's paste an image in here. And you can see I've got just a fairly standard image. Let's add a border to it so we can see the edges of it. In the past, if I wanted to add a caption to this, I could do it many ways. Like for instance, I could add a text box, put that text box just underneath, shrink it down, and set a style for it, you know, and have my caption. I could also put a title above it if I wanted to, the same way. But now there's an easy way to do that in Pages. If I select the image here, go to Format Style, I've got two checkboxes, Title and Caption. If I turn on Caption, you'll see a text box appear underneath. I can click on it there and you could see there's a small text box there. It's part of the image, it's not a separate element. Likewise, if I click Title, you'll see a title appear at the top, another little box, part of the image, not a separate thing. Now I can select either one of these and I'll see a new sidebar here under Format. In addition to Style, Image, and Arrange, with this box selected I'll see Title here, and with this box selected I'll see Caption. If I just select the image I won't see either one of those, so I have to click to select something like the title. Now to change the text all I need to do is click in here and type, you know, my title. And you can see it's a special object title style. I can use any style I want and I can customize this any way I want. But this special object title style is something I can update. You'll see it updated in other titles as well. So for instance, I can make it a bit bigger here if I wanted to. I could do the same thing here with caption. So you can see caption here, and let's make this italic, maybe a little smaller, and maybe right justified. So now you can see I've easily added a title and a caption to this image. You do have another option here under Format Style with the image selected. You see the checkboxes, and to the right of that you can say I want the title to be on the top or the bottom. If you put it at the bottom then the title appears first and then the caption under it. It's just another way you could do it. Now with one of these selected you can, in addition to changing all of the different font and character stylings here, you can go to Layout and change the text inset and other things that you normally would change with text. But you can't change the gap between title and the image itself. The same thing with the caption. You always still have the old way. You can still do a text box or shape above or below and have it exactly how you want it. But for using this quick and easy titles and captions feature, it stays at this distance from the image. Now further down the document here I can add an image. I'll just paste a new one in here and I will do the same thing here. I'll add a title and caption. And you can see it's using the styles there. So I've got, you know, the object title style and the object caption style. If I were to change this, like let's say make the caption a bit more gray and update object caption, you could see it updates here as well. So styles work the same as they normally do. Now you can use captions for more than just images. For instance, you can use them in shapes. Let's put a simple shape here and you could see I could add a title and caption to the shape. You could also add it to shapes that you draw. So create your own shapes and then add a title and caption to those. You can also add them to tables. So I had a default table here and you can see there's a title and caption option there. Before we did have a title option for tables. Now we have both. You can also do this with charts. So I have title and caption for those. You don't have the option in most charts to put the title at the bottom. But I'll show you how to get around that in a minute. In some types of charts you have something a little different. For instance, in a donut chart you have title can be in the center or the top. Now if you drag and drop a video in here you can also do titles and captions for a video. Even a text box, if I just select the box, not the text inside of it, I can add a title and caption to it. Which makes sense since text boxes are pretty much just like shapes except without the shape. Now you can also use them in groups. So let's add some shapes here and group them together. So I'll select each one of these and I'll do Arrange Group. Now the group itself under Format here has title and caption. So you can group together a bunch of different elements and have a title and caption for all of those. This is how you can put a title and caption wherever you want. So for instance, for a donut chart, if you really want to have one at the bottom, you could go and add a basic shape here. Just make it a white box and put it behind the chart there. Select both. So now both are selected. Group them together. And now I can do a title and caption for the group, and you can see it appears above and below. So you can combine elements to get what you want. One weird thing about titles and captions is they don't rotate. So I can select this group here, and if I rotate the group, you can see the title and caption will just stay completely horizontal. The same thing with just rotating a single object. So if I go to arrange here and I rotate this shape, or it could be an image, you can see the title and caption remain horizontal. Now you can still go and use a text box as a title and another one as a caption, group them all together and rotate them just like you want. So you have complete control to get the result you want. The titles and captions feature is really just a very quick way to have a title and or a caption to an image or other object that will work in most cases. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.